This is how you contain the worst nuclear disaster in humanity's history. This is the new safe confinement structure at Reactor 4 at Chernobyl. In 1986, the nuclear power plant here exploded, and that is a sentence you never ever want to hear. The local area was evacuated, and it won't be safe to live in for millennia. To get here, you need special permissions, although it's become a bit easier in recent years. In the months after the disaster, a concrete sarcophagus, it's called the shelter object, was built around the damaged reactor. It was constructed rapidly and desperately. It cost a lot of lives, and it used a megaton of concrete and metal, and it worked, but it won't hold forever. And it was built on top of the unstable debris of the old reactor. But over there is its replacement, still under construction. It's the new safe confinement, and it has cost more than $1.5 billion. It is enormous, a steel arch 100 meters high. When it's done, it'll be hauled by steel cables on enormous tracks over the reactor over the course of a week. And once it's there, the sides will be filled in and the reactor will be contained again, ready to be decommissioned safely. This is the world's largest movable structure, although it's only going to have to move once. And it's got some pretty astonishing design requirements. It can't let anything leak out, and it has to withstand everything that Ukraine's weather can possibly throw at it for 100 years. But just think about that. $1.5 billion for something that'll last 100 years. That's great, provided in that 100 years, we can find the money, time and technology to save and dispose of all the radioactive waste that's currently in there. Will we do that? Or, once there's not an imminent threat of disaster, will we kick it down the road for a future generation to deal with? In 100 years, when this arch is at the end of its lifespan, will we be dismantling it and celebrating a job well done? Or will we be spending another huge sum building its replacement?